A ratio is a comparison of two quantities, and typically this comparison is made using division. So the way we write a ratio is like this. We have A compared to B. And in English, the way we say this and the way we write this is expressed as the ratio A to B. And this just gives a sense or a comparison of how A relates to B. Let me give you an example or two to help you wrap your mind around this idea. Let's say that there was a pizza, and let's say we are going to compare how many pieces of pizza or how much pizza I would eat as an adult compared to my four-year-old son. So let's say for every two pieces of pizza that I eat, so here's two slices of pizza that I would eat, my son would probably eat only one slice because he's much younger. And so that's the ratio 2 to 1. 2 to 1 represents the amount of pizza I eat compared to the amount of pizza that my four-year-old son eats. And the nice thing about ratios is ratios stay equivalent even if you consider larger amounts. For example, if I now, suddenly got hungry and wanted to eat four slices of pizza, that would be equivalent to my son eating two slices of pizza. If that ratio stays the same, then the quantity or the comparison would stay equivalent even if the individual numerical values increased. So we would have the ratio 2 to 1, that's the amount of pizza I eat compared to my son, would be equivalent to me eating four slices while he eats two. Or if I eat six slices, that would be comparable to him eating three, as long as the ratio was 2 to 1. And we can even compare quantities that don't even have the same units. For example, if we were in a car and we went a total of 120 miles on a trip, and it took us 2 hours to go that far. So we could make a ratio out of that. We could say 120 miles compared to the 2 hours that it took us on that trip. So the ratio is 120 to 2. And you could take any equivalent ratio and rewrite this. For example, this is the same as the ratio 60 miles in 1 hour. And the reason that is because 120 divided by 2 gives us 60, or 60 over 1. And so using this ratio, you could determine how far we would go in any amount of hours. For example, let's say we wanted to determine the distance that we traveled in 3 hours. Well, an equivalent ratio to 60 over 1 as a denominator of 3 would be 180 miles in 3 hours, assuming that we've maintained the same ratio, the same speed of 60 miles per hour. So anyways, one thing I want to stress to you in this video is that a ratio is actually different than something else we study quite often in algebra called a proportion. We're going to study proportions in the next video. Now, I'll go ahead and give you a sneak peek. A proportion is when you have one ratio set equal to another ratio. So we actually got close to talking about proportions right here in this example, because if you look at my pen here, if I write 60 over 1 equals x over 3, which is what we were doing, 60 miles in 1 hour was what distance in 3 hours, this would be called a proportion, not a ratio. The left-hand side is a ratio, and the right-hand side is a ratio, but them set equal to each other is called a proportion, which we're going to look at in the next video.